this way, Papa. Come and see. Will it hatch? Can we take it home?
Yes, my darling. Of course we can take it home.
Your faith shackles your vision, Professor. It is an iron coffin that keeps you from grasping the future. We require a new deity, one of steam and the wheel of magnetism and progress. The old god is nothing more than a lame hog, spitting back offal at mankind.
Listen, Papa. Hold the egg to your ear. You can hear the sea.
water in his shoes. Always the water and the sparks of the embers of the wheels. It's too bony! It's too damn bony!
These men, Professor, these so-called men of vision, they would shackle the masses to a wheel and turn it till their backs break. All for that opiate, the lure of profit. These fools who lackey them, these priests, these officials, this government, they make pigs of us all.
But what solution, my dear man? How to break a cycle? You cannot simply remove the promise of a better world for these unfortunates. In the workhouses, in the orphanages, the belief in heaven is surely the only succor one can find.
We do not need to wait. We can bring forth paradise now. We can speed the passion with only a small... just a small sacrifice, we can free our shackles and deliver them to paradise now.
Thank you.
Over there, place it in the corner. What? You think I speak Prussian? Do I look like an inbred hog, sir? Who gives a damn what it contains? Just set it down carefully and leave me be!
have to find another way to the tunnel. Take care in this place, Mandus. It is the crucible of the evil that stalks these corridors.
It fell onto his hands and they eroded in front of me. To stumps. To stumps. Next time we will use an equal mix of infusion vitae and orgone disperser. No, just take him out. You can dump him in the river for all I care.
dangerous allowing this filthy discharge to collect so close to the core.
We can use the flow to drive the turbines. There will always be a torrent of excreta flooding through these tunnels. We can use this to supplement the steam production and ensure constancy.
God, the stench! This fecal matter is the true product of the age.
are waiting for you.
But we can save them. We can set them free. We can replace a rotten old world with a clean new one.
Mr. Landis, you sound every bit the fanatic.
Well, how can I be otherwise, Professor? How can any man of ethics simply stand by and watch this world drown in its own excrement?
And your engineer, this visionary with whom you embarked upon this course, does he show you? Indeed, the poor fellow has seen it all before. Now, this is not the first great civilization he has wept for. And so you set about things immediately upon your return.
Naturally. These things cannot be left to rot upon the tree.
And sponsors were remarkably easy to find. I tell you, Professor, a trail of greed will reach men to your door like pigs to trumpets.
Thank you.
You seem to have undergone quite a profound conversion in Mexico, Mr. Mendel.
You could not have seen it yourself and not, Professor. As we disembarked, even through my fever, I saw the detritus of this so-called progress. I saw starvation and disease, rot and destruction polluting the waters of the Empire. We are ruinous, you and I, and all of us, and we make the world unclean.
And you took it upon yourself.
I said you.
Thank you.
You set me upon a mantelpiece, and then you went into the house and buried the servants and reset you and I on recrafting them. And then you went into the garden and buried those tiny shattered skulls alone. For your children, Mandus, to spare them the world you have created for us all. And they feel no pain. The process is completely humane.
Humane, Professor? That we judge the acceptable level of suffering by the human condition? Ask the beggar, Professor. Ask the orphan. Ask the whore. Ask the starving, Professor. The weak, the sick, the filthy. Ask them to define your humane.
Daddy!
set them all free. I rise. I will rise to bleach the sky and still the water. I will spin the world wheel and set the future upon the path to redemption.
Where are my children? You promised me my children.
My time is come, Morphling. Morphling!
Boys. Boys. I'm sorry. I'm so sorry.
And, emerging, I raised my head to an uncaring sun, and I cursed this world of pain and despair. This civilization built on the ricketed bones of the unfortunate, on the greed and swell of mammon and empire. Cradling a stone egg in my jacket, I kissed my children farewell, and I called. Will it hurt them?
A cleansing fire always burns, little Mandus, but it purifies and it makes anew. Did it hurt to carve out the fevered flesh? Did it hurt to cut free the gangrenous foot? Ask instead this. Can we save them?
When did I say that? That is not me. That is not me! What have I done?
Thank you. Do you hear me, Madness? This is what you planned.
Thank you.
drained and bled and freed from the prison of the flesh. Free to ascend as smoke to the stars.
And the good? The worthy? How will we save them?
Show me these worthy, Mandus. Show me these good. I do not see them.
Thank you.
machine. I know what you fear. I will rain excrement into your very soul. I will destroy you.
You are too low to mend. My great works are almost begun.
I am here again, at the foot of those stairs. Towards the red light of the nursery. Sunset in the window like a bleeding sky. The horizon a slit throat. The seeping dark grain of guilt grass. I am the jaguar-faced man. I am the feathered serpent. This priesthood is mine.
I can meet him, your great engineer. How marvelous. I must say, Mr. Manders, my excitement is almost unseemly.
Yes, I can see that. Step this way, Professor. I will be right behind you.
Landis. Landis, where the devil are you? I can't see a damn thing. Landis! We are the pig, Professor. They are all the pigs.